سيدنا وأبينا محمد وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين وصحبه المنتجبين. مرحب بجناب السيد العميد أستاذ دكتور مجيد جاسم عميد كلية الآداب، والأستاذ دكتور مرضى ذنون، وأساتذة الأفاضل من قسم اللغة الإنجليزية وقسم الترجمة، والأخوة والأبناء الطلبة والطالبات. في هذه الآداب على قاعة الفرزدق لإقامة الورشة الثقافية الثالثة للمشروع الثقافي المشترك بين البصرة وبوسطن، وفاء وإكراما لشهدائنا الأبرار نقرأ لهم سورة الفاتحة. البصرة بوسطن هو مشروع ثقافي يراد منه خلق اتصال بين المثقفين والأكاديميين والطلبة في جامعة في منطقة بوسطن تحديدا. هدف المشروع هو تشجيع الحوار بين أفراد من بلدين فرقت بينهما الجغرافيا والحدود والحروب، وهذا المشروع يتم عن طريق تبادل الخبرات والأفكار الإبداعية. المشروع يعرض نتاج التبادل على جمهور أكبر عن طريق إقامة المعارض وتقديم عروض وإداءات فنية متنوعة. مبدئياً كان المشروع مصمم ليكون تجربة لاكتشاف تقنيات التعليم المختلفة، ويركز حالياً على التعاون الثقافي والفني بين توأمين من الأكاديميين أو المثقفين. على مستوى الرسم لدينا من البصرة الأخت الفنانة أسماء الحسان، تقابلها الفنانة آن لوير من مؤسسة فور بوينت في بوسطن. على مستوى الموسيقى لدينا الأستاذ قيس عودة من كلية فنون جميلة، يقابله في العمل يورك أوركسترا. على مستوى العمل الآثاري والتاريخ القديم من جامعة البصرة الدكتور عادل هاشم كلية الآداب، تقابله عالمة الآثار كاثرين جروسمان من معهد ماساتشوستس في بوسطن. في مجال الشعر أيضا من البصرة الشاعرة والفنانة إلهام ناصر الزويدي بتوأمة مع ميتش مانيك. التنسيق العام لهذا المشروع مشترك بين مارك ميلر والأخ دكتور عامر عبد الزهر الأزرقي، وهو تدريسي سابق في كليتنا وحاليا أستاذ في تورنتو في كندا. انضم إلى المشروع أيضا الدكتور سامر طالب، تدريسي من قسم اللغة الإنجليزية بمعية نخبة من طلبة قسمي اللغة الإنجليزية والترجمة لقراءة المسرحيات التي طرحت ضمن هذا المشروع. في البداية كان هناك حول هذا المشروع، في البداية كان هناك حوار ثنائي مباشر على الانترنت بين ثلاث ثنائيات من المثقفين والأكاديميين. تضمن الحوار هو إيجاد قواسم مشتركة ومتباينة بين تجارب كل من الأساتذة الأمريكان ونظرائهم العراقيين. الطور الثاني هو المرحلة الإبداعية. أثناء سير الحوار عبر الانترنت دخل المشروع مرحلة الإبداع. في ربيع 2016 باحثون مسرحيون وشعراء شاركوا في النقاش مع الفنانين والمثقفين. مثلا كانت هناك محاضرات متبادلة مباشرة جامعة البصرة وبوسطن. عزفت مقطوعة للأستاذ قيس عودة بعنوان بيل جوني ماير. الطور الثالث والمرحلة الثالثة لهذا المشروع يتوج بفعاليات تعرض على الجمهور لمشاهدة التعاون المشترك بين الأكاديميين والمثقفين في البلدين. أول عرض كان في بوسطن أكتوبر 2016 في القاعة الكبرى للجامعة، وفي سبتمبر في المدينة ذاتها البصرة، مع اختصارات لعدد من فقراته تلاؤما مع المكان والزمان. الآن الكلمة لزميلي دكتور سامر يصف المشروع باللغة الإنجليزية، لأن هناك عدد من المتلقين والناطقين والمشتركين معنا في اللغة الإنجليزية. تفضل.
Thank you very much. Okay, just an introduction about the Basra Boston project. This project has started some years ago, and it is a collaborative project between the city of Basra and the city of Boston, and it involves staff members, students, and artists from the city of Basra and the city of Boston. The project tries to engage the two organizations of the United States and Iraq in dialogue, and also tries to promote understanding between the two nations. Tries to shatter the misunderstanding and the misconception and the stereotypes that are very common in the media between the two nations. The project, as my colleague has mentioned, started some time ago. There were some workshops in Boston. Last June, in the College of Art, we tried to make two stage readings of two plays by American writers, In the Reeds by Amy Merrill and Bright's Look Forward by Johnny Miller. And this year, two workshops were held in Boston at October 1st and November the 4th. They involved recitations of Iraqi poems, the playing of music by Dr. Pace called Panorama Joy, and also there were some lectures about Iraq. So this gathering here is to celebrate the third and initiate the third workshop in this project. And it will involve a stage reading by, of the play by John Miller, Bright's Look Forward. It is followed by poetry recitation by the Iraqi poet, the Basra poet, Ilham Zubaydi. And also will be a recitation of poems by Mitch Manning, a poet and academic from Boston. It will also involve paintings by Anne Lawyer, the American artist, and also paintings from Iraqi artists, from Ilham Zubaydi and students from the Departments of English and the Department of Translation. And it will end with a musical by the staff from the Department of Music at the College of Fine Arts. Thank you very much.
It's a stage reading for the Rise Look Forward by John Mayer. For those who don't know what the stage reading is, actually it's where the characters sit and read the dialogue instead of performing it. So I hope that you will join the mother and Aqil Mousse, the husband of the hero, the British sergeant and the British officer and the morgue officer and other people, including Hero. Hero opens her eyes.
Saddam Hussein lasted 24 years. He hated Basra, the city I was born in. He used to say, Basra is the bride of the Gulf, but she's a peasant. Peasant brides deserve 3 days of mass treatment and then chase them to the fields. By the year 2016, it has been 13 years since the invasion of Iraq. Remove Saddam Hussein from power.
Hero sits up.
Despite the violence of this period, we are not all dead. In 1987, we had a population of perhaps 400,000. Now, despite of all the thirst, the starved fired in the intervening years, we number more than 1 million people.
Everyone sits up, starts cleaning off the blood and filth, except the British officer and British sergeant, Hero.
It was not a magic trick. We just kept having sex and kept having babies. I imagine that if you've got a little one to hold, you can keep eating and drinking whatever life puts in front of you.
Woman studies law. Man goes shopping. Two young men play drafts. A young man and a young woman assemble a machine gun. Hero.
The story this time begins in 2007, where the British military abandoned my city, Basra, to the militias.
With a 9-volt battery, the two young men launch the Katyusha rocket, which vanishes in an explosion. Everyone ducks. Everyone slowly gets up. Woman studies law. Man goes shopping. Two young men play drafts. A young man and young woman complete the assembly of a machine gun. Young woman shows off the machine gun to one of the drafts players, a militiaman, in Arabic. Young woman, in Arabic, talking about the machine gun.
Snow has heavy, as I expected, but the bullets were low, they are loads.
Young man, in English looking at the gun.
What do you think this is? Texas?
Militiaman, in Arabic. A militiaman forces the young man off stage at gunpoint. British officer and British sergeant rise from the dead and clean off. Enter Aqil, Hero, aside.
But the British military left the city of Basra in 2007. Some called it a defeat. The British were under constant attack from the Shia militias.
An incoming mortar and round whistles overhead. An alarm goes off. Everyone hits the dirt.
Take cover. Incoming.
Incoming.
The mortar rounds blows up nearby. Still taking cover.
Now.
Wait a second.
Now would be a good time for a joke. Someone tell a joke.
Incoming.
Another mortar round. British officer.
Incoming.
Impact.
The British stayed in good spirit. My husband worked as a translator. His name was Aqil. But the British called him William. I also worked as a translator, but I refused to work for the British.
Stop drinking at home because he's starting getting blasted at work.
It is not so easy to tell when you are joking, my friend.
Really? Well, it's very easy to notice when you are leaving.
Why you are so nervous, William? You are earning a good living, but everything has to come to an end.
Working for you, it costs a lot of money to keep things quiet. Getting a ride to work, for example, I pay extra to the driver to be very quiet. And when I stop paying him, he may stay not quiet.
Hero, aside.
A confession. After two miscarriages and constant arguments about living in his mother's house, I'm not sure I loved Abi, but on my unsuccessful journey to have a baby, he was the only man. So when he went missing, I got upset.
My house and to be closer to the British come back.
It was safer that way.
That was a lie. It was because you were arguing. And he was embarrassed by you. You embarrassed him. You start to humiliate him.
Hero, sorry.
Perhaps not quite like Sherlock.
What?
Nothing. Look, I don't know where he is. I think maybe he just left me. He knew the job was ending. He kept the money and he left me.
Idiot. Where would he go? I'm on Basra.
Syria, maybe.
That is the other side of the world.
Syria's not that far. And it is safe there.
Safety is for children, not for adults. My son is a man.
Sorry.
When the Americans and the British first arrived, I was oblivious to whether Saddam would stay or go. He left, but even now, I walk around and remember Saddam's picture being painted on this building or hanging in that restaurant. I remember my sister, when she was little, she told me that she was going to marry Saddam one day, but my mother told her that she was too young for him. And anyway, Saddam was already married. This painted picture stared at Basra intently, with a sincere smile that harbored a brotherly hate against us for a long time. I will never forget him, but the next generation will not know who he was. That was the generation I would want my baby to be a part of, if my baby ever existed.
Now he's been missing for a year. Come on, let's go. I just wanted to know what happened to him.
Hero, aside.
Mother takes us to the police station. When I look at buildings, instead of seeing pictures of Saddam, I see posters that say, Law builds a nation.
To Mother.
To the British?
Where are we going?
To the British.
No, absolutely not.
You speak English. You must talk to them.
So what if I speak English?
They will help.
They may do many things, but they will not help.
What if he was in the UK now, or America? They would tell us.
If he isn't, he went into the city.
He was a man. He had to learn a living.
He was not earning a living. He was earning money. And on the radio, constantly remind us not to do it. I'll tell you a joke I heard a religious man say.
No, you will not tell me a joke. You have no sense of humor.
I do have a sense of humor.
Well, I have no sense of humor, so no.
It goes like this. Three men say to one another, which of us is the most vulgar, crude, and evil? The three men decide to hold a competition to find out. The first man sees a woman carrying wood atop her head. He knocks the wood off her head and he beats her. The second man, he is even worse. He tears off her clothes and he rapes her. The third man, he just stands back and he watches. When the other two men ask the third man what he will do to prove that he is evil, the man just laughs and he crosses, or who helps them out, like a thief, like William. In a country like this where they hate collaborators like that, you made William go for work for the British. That is very generous of Aqil. We do not go to the British, we go to the Moor.
He's not dead.
We go to the Moor, Mother. The police won't help us unless we say we have been to the Moor and looked at the photos.
He's not dead.
Good. Then we won't have to see the pictures.
Aside.
We sit.